Oh, we have a sheep and a very sad shepherd man over here.
I'm so sad because I was scared by a dragon today.
C-S-T-E.
How would you want to bet this is a sleeping spell?
Okay, so...
it's a freaking sleeping spell! It couldn't be possibly be more obvious.
We didn't do anything to your sheep.
You're just a bad shepherd. Also, insert a Bible reference here, and yes. You know, the parable of the lost lamb?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, seriously, man? You seriously falling victim to your old magic ship? Just wake him up.
Must have had a long night. Okay, so it's A. Oh, we don't have the A note.
Oh.
Well, that's gonna make things a tad difficult. Can we change the sheep to gold? Oh, wait. I have an idea. This is the greatest spell that we can do for this.
You're turning the sheep green, aren't you?
I'm gonna try.
Well, good for you. Good job, Davar. Good job. Perfectly mimetic green sheep. That is brilliant.
I can't believe that worked.
There are no words.
Can I change it to gold? Okay, I wonder if he will notice if the sheep are gone when he wakes up. I have to see if he notices them.
Okay, how does that even work? The sleeping spell, I mean.
Yeah.
Look at my sheep! Look at them! Look at them! What did you do to them? They look ridiculous! I agree.
Yes.
How am I supposed to watch sheep when I can barely see?
That's supposed to be the point.
Come on, you guys, move it.
And he sends them back.
So what was accomplished at the end?
Nothing. Other than making the sheep green.
Can you open the sheep?
Okay.
No, I'm joking.
Yes, I know. I'm just... can we fill them with liquids? Can we make them drunk sheep?
Oh, Davar, that's disgusting.
Make them into drunk sheep?
How about we turn them into a sheep-nado? Sheep-nado!
it was too late. I was too busy looking for the spell notepad.
Okay, let's turn the sheep into a sheep nado with the magic of Twister.
I thought that won't work.
That would have been so cool.
Wait, maybe we could turn the sheep invisible.
Yeah. Why didn't we think of that to begin with?
Okay,
No, you have to turn it to green first. Oh yes, it is so amusing, isn't it?
I'm sorry, but I just can't help but find it amusing. Okay, let's see, where is it again? Oh, it turned invisible. D double C G.
Da da da.
Didn't work. Guess they don't want to look at me anyway. What? Can I do it in reverse?
Oh, wait, you can only turn yourself invisible.
Let me try in reverse anyway, just to be sure. Because, okay, where is it? Am I doing it right? Oh, I'm doing the wrong way. Did the wrong way, I think, because I'm in... okay, so... D. Yeah, so it's I must have got confused. Okay. So we don't have anything to do for him. So, should we walk this way? Nope, we cannot walk that way. Wait, where are you going? Bobbin?
I have no idea.
Oh, he's going across.
Where are you going, Bobbin?
Somewhere. Getting us somewhere closer to the end of the game already.
Somewhere over the green rainbow. Field of greenness, and there's a hut over there. We will go to that village and scare some more folks. That was returning to dragons.
It's Sheep Jesus!
Hello, little sheep Jesus. I bring you a gift from the East. It is a bottle of perfume.
Oh, someone's out there.
Uh-huh. Okay, click on the lamb. Click on the lamb.
Okay, so...
Sheep Jesus. Hello there.
Who said that?
It is I.
A nice lady. Oh.
Oh.
Who are you? You sounded a bit more manly.
I am she who sent for you. I am also very bad English.
Huh?
I am named Fleas, first chosen of the Guild of Shepherds. And you are obviously the mighty wizard I hired from the Guild of Mages.
What?
You are so not.
There must be some mistake.
I'm never wrong! Your modesty is very charming, but there is no mistake.
I think there is a lot of mistakes.
Because I am so more intelligent than anyone else, and I'm an independent woman. And boy, the guards were extremely impressed with your display of magic today.
Hey, same smile as Elaine.
You're also young and quite well-mannered. Also, you're ugly as hell. Please keep your cloak all the time on. Were our plight not so serious, it might amuse me to know you better. Plight? One of our clients placed an order for 10,000 fattened sheep and sheep Jesus over there. That's enough to feed an army. I fear that may be exactly what the clerics have in mind. Oh, the Guild of the Clerics, which of course are the bad guys, because they are clerics and the church is evil. But we do not concern ourselves with our customers use our products. They probably won't get their sheep anyway.
No, why not?
Because their leader is named Mandible. A local dragon seems to have acquired a taste for fresh mutton. Our sheep are bad, and he's kidnapping sheep just
as we speak.
Right about now.
He's well timed.
Only a mage can save us from this winged pestilence. Okay, we need to hire 13 dwarves and a hobbit, and then.
Anyway, nice chatting you, Miss Fleece of the third game of the Loom series that was never meant to be.
Wait, what?
Yeah, a bit of backstory. Apparently Loom was meant to be a trilogy of games, but due to how poorly Loom went, but as well as the whole team not wanting to continue the series, the two other games were not created. Basically, two characters you see in this game were supposed to be the main characters of the next one. The second one we have not met yet, but Fleece here was meant to be the main character of the third one.
There is not a second Loom game.
No, that's what I'm trying to tell you. There was...
Yes, you put it into words in a way that sounded like there was a second, but never a third.
I said there was meant to be a trilogy, but there never was.
That would explain why the game ends the way it does.
Yes, but we will not say until we get to the end of it.
Okay, so have you clicked on the sheep already?
Yes, maybe we clicked on the sheep.
Maybe, You mean to utterly,
lamb.
You mean to tell me that Sheep Jesus doesn't give you any new spell?
Sheep Jesus, how could you fail us in this great time? Oh, she's not gonna make it.
Oh. Her mother was carried off by the dragon the day after she gave birth.
Wow, talk about good timing.
My songs of healing don't seem... Your songs of healing.
Songs?
We shepherds are known for them. At least I thought we were.
Will you teach us this song of healing?
Only my grandsire taught me the magic notes. We said we got them from some other guild in exchange for the secret of stealth. And we aced Metal Gear Solid in one single playthrough.
Okay, Aga. I guess
I'm not very good yet.
So she says it's a healing spell.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so Aga is a healing spell.
So if you do the reverse, can you actually make people sick?
It actually does the same spell because it's like, there's no reverse to it.
I get it. That sucks.
Oh, I know what could help with this.
Oh, you want to turn the lamb into a green lamb, don't you? You sick psycho.
The lamb doesn't look too well. Maybe I shouldn't bother her.
Good. Okay, so talk to the shepherd one more time. Maybe she has something that you can...
Okay, let's try to look at...
Okay, apparently the shepherd girl is not even there. It's all a figment of your imagination.
Okay, she's opened her eyes a little.
I'll try it again.
Oh, it's just an excuse to get... I like how Bobbin's staff shines when someone else plays a note near him.
You know, you'd think the staff is memorizing the spell, but no.
No.
Is there anything else in this hat?
Other than Sheep Jesus, no.
Okay, let's leave Sheep Jesus to the tender and care of Lady Mary there. Of the Holy Mary.
We have to...
There is a lot of biblical symbolisms going around in this game.
Yes, best of luck with us to the dragon, yes.
Oh, you mean the dragon that just stole a sheep right about now under your very nose?
She's gone!
Oh, no, she's invisible.
Oh, yes, that's probably it.
I don't see the reason why she should be invisible right now, but who cares? They are the wizards of stealth.
I know! I know what we're to do. This fixes everything.
Turn them invisible.
No.
Turn the entire flock of sheep green!
Yes!
I don't believe this. I don't believe this. This game is actually indulging into your perverted fantasies of green sheeps. Ship
we got captured!
And the dragon kidnaps you! I love the fact that it just appeared literally the moment you turn all sheep into green. It's... Well, silly me. This is what I get for being in a hurry. Hello, Smog. Huh? You look well. Thought you felt a little scrawny.
Already okay. I have an idea what to do, but I won't do it just yet.
This is the Hobbit. You have to turn invisible. This is so obvious. Where'd you get your manners? Stop staring at me. Really? Oh, he's a shy dragon.
Was I staring? Sorry.
Forget it. Don't pay any attention to me. Is it a shy dragon? I get crabby on an empty stomach.
Uh-oh.
That reminds me. I have to eat you.
Oh, are you going to incinerate me now?
What a weird thing to ask. Incinerate you? My, aren't you the foxy one? You've come to the wrong lair, if that's what you're after. Oh, he's dealt with suicidal maniacs before. Listen, sweetie, it's a lady dragon. I've been on fire since my last mating season. And you don't want to know how long ago that was. Are you serious?
We're having a talk with this dragon about mating seasons.
is a sexually repressed lady dragon? Really?
There's a joke in here somewhere.
Is this the dragon from Shrek? What, honey? Doesn't fit my lifestyle. Just between you and me, the stuff gives me the willies.
Don't say willies, considering what you're just talking about.
You're a dragon, have some dignity. Okay, you know what? You know what? I'll be honest with you, Devar. So far, this dragon is my favorite character. At least she has an actual personality that we can actually get something of.
Yes.
If only she were the main character.
Yes, but you're playing as a dragon stealing sheep.
But in truth, she's just sexually repressed because no other dragons are around because they're all extinguishing. But then she embarks into a redemption arc and ends up saving the world from evil. And a race too. And also fighting against discrimination because humanity hates dragons. And all that. Did you just turn an entire stack of gold into straws?
Yes.
Aren't we clever today? Just put it back before you leave, or I'll kill you. This is...
Ooh.
This is the most... You mean to tell me she's just going to let you leave?
Apparently.
This is the kindest, most affable dragon I've ever met.
Can we talk to her again? Can't keep your eyes off me, eh?
I am not interested, little boy. You're simply not in my league.
And suddenly fan fictions were written.
Oh god, don't say that. Please turn the straws back into gold. Please, we don't want to offend the very generous and very, very, very generous Lady Dragon host.
Yes, she actually is a nice dragon lady once you get past she ate sheep.
Well, she has to eat to... Well, she has to survive. She has to eat, doesn't she?
Yeah.
She has the right to. Thanks, sweetie. Glad you remembered how to do it.
Well, of course, because I have it written down.
So, I think we can leave whenever we want, and this dragon lady just won't bother us.
Apparently, she just wants company.
Devar, can we spend the rest of the game inside this dungeon, please? I want to keep company to the dragon lady. This seems like the best moment in the game so far.
I know. That's because I really like her character, even though it's a bit flirty for a dragon. But
yes, no. That's exactly why it's interesting. When is the last time you saw a flirty dragon? Well, aside from the dragon from Shrek, but that doesn't count. She doesn't really have an interesting personality or even an interesting speech pattern. She doesn't speak.
Well, we could
this came before, so yes.
Well, this could be... Okay, I don't know. Wait, can we make her fall asleep?
What would be the point? I mean, she's not obstructing you in any way possible. She's just being your host. That is so generous of her.
I know, nice. But we can't seem to get out of here.
We can't?
No, we can't get out of here. So I need to figure out a way to get...
Then why did you say we can leave whenever you want or something?
I have no idea. Can I turn into a dragon and then fly out?
Oh, I wouldn't recommend that.
What do I do? We turn into fire.
Put it out.
I'll get it. Oh, we're gonna have to do this.
That was not funny, young man. We do not approve.
You're a fire-breathing dragon.
We are Luna, princess of the night.
Oh, I hate to do this, but it has to be done.
What?
You... Oh, wait, I have to do it in reverse.
Wait, you're going to... Oh, no. Why? Why do this? I mean...
It's all this... The game wants us to do this, Mad Hog. Blame the game, not me.
I hate this game. She was so nice. She was not even going to eat us. She was going to let us go. She was even amiable and hospitable, and we repay her generosity by burning her only home?
Yes.
Who is the real bad guy here? Who is the real villain?
Us, I would say.
That's a rhetorical question.
Oh, wait. It didn't seem to work. Okay, let's try it again.
There are no words to express my frustration right now.
I feel very bad about this.
Very, very bad.
We're sending the only likable character away. Oh, look, she was sat in front of the exit.
We couldn't, you know, just have the option of asking her to let us pass through. Maybe she would have complied because she was a very, very likable person, I want to say.
Yes, I can't believe that we have to,
Okay, seriously, guys, I am not even joking. I'm seriously pissed off at the game right now. I'm seriously, honestly pissed off that we had to do this in order to progress on this really, really now atrocious game. Just
she seemed like a nice person. Why can't we just ask her to not do it and...
That's what I wanted to know. I mean, there are not even dialogue options in this game.
I just feel like as if this game just made us do a bad thing to someone that didn't deserve it, even though they were eating people's sheep.
But they were doing it because they're evil, because they have to eat to survive. It's the don't blame the dragon, blame nature.
Oh, it's this sort of thing. We're going through a maze now.
I hope it's not a maze.
I hope not too, but alright. And we got some nice, relaxing music playing in the background while we go through this maze.
Yeah.
We got somewhere. Somewhere with a hole in the floor, and stairs.
So now that I think about it, we did not only burn our home, we burn our only physical possessions. We burned the dragon's hoard. Burning away the dragon's hoard is like it's like burning away the very soul of a dragon. That was so dastardly of us.
Can't get there from here.
That was so dastardly of Bobbin. I do not approve.
I do not approve of it either. It's... I know we're kind of harping on about it, folks, but she was a good character.
I mean, we only knew her for 5 minutes and already she was the most likable character in this entire game. I mean, she was a kind flirtation, sexually repressed dragon. What lady? That's the most brilliant character ever devised.
Apparently I fell from somewhere.
Wait, I think you can look at the water.
Yes. I wonder if you have to drain the liquid.
The water is important.
Oh. A. Dun, F. Dun, F. Dun, dun, dun. Alpha. Is that my reflection? Ugh.
I knew it. It was ugly.
Okay. Okay, something to do with water or reflection. So, I'm gonna guess it's a mirror of some description?
Let's try that.
Okay. So...
Fa, 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 fa.
Okay. Okay, it doesn't work on this particular water.
Okay, let's go on with our pointless adventure of pointlessness.
Okay, let me see if I can drain the liquid here. E double F G. Can we take away the liquid? Plenty full enough already.
I had to do the
opposite. Wait, we have to do it in the other way. G F F E.
And it works.
I thought it would, and inexplicably large jewel over here.
Another sphere? Seriously? Did someone just place these spheres randomly waiting for you to pass by?
Volcano?
You're the Chosen War and some other cred.
Okay, so what else? It's her again.
That again.
And she's telling us the same thing.
That swan is your spoiler.
Yes, we...
Mandible! Hey, it's Bishop Mandible!
He looks like guy from Spaceballs, you know, Dark Helmet. I forgot the actor's name, but...
Nick Moranis.
Yeah, he looks like Nick Moranis.
Let's see.
And now I cannot stop thinking of him as Nick Moranis now.
Everybody got that?
Okay.
It is true, Lone Star. I am your father's cousin's brother's something roommate.
And what does that make us? Absolutely nothing.
Okay. Okay. Can you actually go somewhere now?
That's what I'm thinking, but by the looks of it, we cannot get anywhere. At this point, I spent 6 minutes trying to find a not-so-obvious exit from this area. Yeah, you don't want to see that, so I'm just going to cut it out. Bring in the cutsmith! Oh, wait. He goes back there. Oh, good lord!
Don't you feel so stupid right now?
My eyes twitching.
You tell me. Okay, we somehow reached the exit, hooray. Whoopty freaking do, woohoo.
I was clicking everywhere as well. And we're going down a long spiral staircase where Bobbins continues to be bitching with his staff.
He was sidewalking on the spiral for a moment. Did you see that?
Yes. I don't know how I got him to do that.
That was pretty cool.
And
I like this slow walking cycle. Okay, so, You know what you need to do? You need to unspiral that spiral over there, so you can actually form right there. Yes, you have to use the reverse twist spiraling spell.
Yes,
it should actually solve all your problems.
Okay, so EDDF. Get there first.
Jeez. You are the worst.
Okay.
All right.
E, D, D, F.
And there you go.
Hey.
So, which means that actually getting down all those stairs in a spiral motion was completely pointless, and we wasted time.
A lot of time. Oh, this is gonna be a lot of editing to get rid of all the pointless stuff.
It's the Dragon Lady. You know, I hope the Dragon Lady actually incinerates you because you deserve it.
Oh,
speaking of which.
Yeah. I don't know about you, man, but I think this might be the best place to kind of stop from here because it's like very, very late right now.
Yes, I think so too. And judging by the sudden change of scenario and the tone, I'd say Dragonfire is about to get real.
Indeed.
Okay, so save the game.
Yes, I will save the game. But, I'd like to say first, thanks for joining us, folks. I know it's kind of a bit jarring to go from something amusing and entertaining to something like this, but I still hope you all enjoyed it, even with our silliness.
And we hope you
join us next time for the Fellow Bravers Game Showcase crossover with Mad Plays.
It's not a crossover, it's the same identical thing, only it has a different name depending on which channel you watch it.
Yes.
It's complicated. Just call it two idiots playing a game, okay? you can't go wrong. Okay, so this has been by Loom, and we shall continue it the next session.
Yes, and I've been blatant advertising of whatever because I have nothing right now because I have no fricks to advertise.
I'm turning you green.
I turn your sticks into gold. No, wait!
Thank you! Bye!
No! Oh, I meant the reverse of that!